Hi there, welcome to week 20 of Social Studies. This week we will finally be wrapping up our unit on the economy. So the economy is such an important piece of information when we're talking about our country, the United States. And it's really important for any country. If we don't have an economy, then quite honestly, there's no job market, there's no money, there's no products to buy. Gonna be like the olden days, basically. We're gonna have to make all of our stuff ourselves. We're gonna have to hunt all of our food. And for some of us, that's just not really something that we're good at, nor is it really something that we want to do. So we have learned over these past several weeks that the economy is really based off of a few things. Number one, we have to have money. Number two, we have to have products. As far as products go, we learned about goods and services, things that are made and things that people provide. We also learned that when we're talking about an economy, we need to have producers and consumers. Producers make the goods or provide the service, and the consumers are the people that use their hard-earned money to buy the products or to buy the services. And then lastly, we've learned about supply and demand or shortage and surplus. And basically all that is saying is supply is what's available, demand is if people want it, how much they want it, how little they want it. Supply and demand really determines how much money we will have to pay or how little money we will have to pay. So we're going to do a review for Monday's class, and we'll do that through Nearpod. Tuesday, you will be taking your quiz, and we will be done with economics. The rest of the week, we will be taking a look at the presidential inauguration. So this actually happened last Wednesday, January 20th, when you guys were off school for that day. So for Wednesday's lesson this week, you will actually watch part of the inauguration. Now, what is an inauguration? That is the swearing in of a new president. So we will get to hear some words from President Biden as well as Vice President Harris. Now, despite what your feelings are on who our president should be, the reality of it is we had an election and somebody was selected. The idea behind these next 3 days is just to learn about our presidential process. So we learned a few weeks before we learned about economics, we learned about the branches of government. And the one branch we learned about was the executive branch, and that is the branch that our president is in charge of. Now, our president is in charge of enforcing the law. Right. So this is why we just want to take a look at the inauguration, and we want to talk about what our president's plans are as far as our country's laws go. So Wednesday, you will watch part of the inauguration. Thursday and Friday, I will have you writing some paragraphs about your thoughts about some of the things that our president is hoping will happen for our country. If after watching that inauguration, you're really not sure what you're supposed to be doing, please let me know. And by all means, we will make sure you get the help that you need. Again, in our country, being that we have a democracy and people vote, oftentimes we have people that have kind of some harsh feelings when their candidate does not win. But again, as a country, we still have our system in place, which means we still have laws that need to be followed, whether you're Republican or Democrat, whether you're a fan of President Biden or former President Trump, the laws that are created don't come from our president. We learn they come from our our legislative branch, Congress, the Senate, and the House of Representatives. Our president is just the person that's in charge of making sure we're doing what we're supposed to do. So I hope that you are willing to listen to the inauguration with some open ears, meaning that even though your candidate may not have won, we're still listening closely to see how our president is going to help our country. If you have any questions, any concerns, any comments, please use chat, raise your hand if you're here. Otherwise, I hope you learned something informative or useful about our new president.